Hey guys, Pastor Brittany here, the Ignite Kids pastor, and I am here to bring you a word, and today I'm going to be talking about contentment. So I'm going to speak to anyone who is struggling with contentment right now. These are the lies that we hear that we aren't good enough, aren't smart enough, aren't doing enough. Those parents that are just really struggling with their kids being home right now and just feeling like we're just not content with our season of life, that everything in us has been flipped upside down right now. And we just want to talk about the constant battle within ourselves that we don't want to believe. We don't want to believe these things, but we allow them to creep in, and then we do. And then we are presented with so much adversity in our minds of what is going on if we are doing the right thing. So I just want to speak a little bit into that today. So we're actually going to be in 1 Timothy 6. And this is Paul telling us that yet true godliness with contentment is of self great wealth. So after all, we brought nothing with us when we came into the world, and we can take nothing with us when we leave it. So if we have enough food and clothing, let us be content. So we fall into a few different lies within ourselves that we have to battle with truth. And that's the biggest thing, is we're told sometimes the grass isn't greener, and we start to value possessions over people at times. And we're starting to think through the things that are making us what we think are content, but it's really not. And like, instead we need to embrace, like Paul talked about, is God, how God sees us, and then put that into action. We embrace that we are meant to do things instead of comparing ourselves to the expectations that we have that aren't even real. Like, we don't even believe that we're doing enough when really we're doing way more than we're actually supposed to be doing. So it's just finding that contentment in what God has given us and going forward with that. It's easy to fall into this if we're not satisfied in God alone. And that's my biggest take home for today, that when we're able to face things with joy and patience, that's Jesus. And that's who he is. And that's, we have that in ourselves. And so we face these situations where we're not content with more of your joy and your patience and your different fruits of the Spirit. So we can rest in him and his provision. And that alone should be enough, that he is enough and that we have him. And so we can face things with who he has made us to be. So therefore, all in all, we're content. We're content with our situations. And it gives us a little bit of a different way and a different perspective to look at things, just like we were talking about in 1 Timothy, that we can rest in God alone. So I encourage you, be encouraged to be content in your season, find the joy in it, and just move forward that way. And I know that we'll find more contentment in the season that we're in and then the craziness that is today. So let's pray. Jesus, we love you, and we just thank you for this time that we can just take a few minutes and just speak on the fact that we're not always going to be content in our lives. We're not always going to feel like everything is put together and exactly the way we want it to be, but we rest in you, and we rest in you alone, that you can feed that hole or that void and just make it so that we are content, and we're content in you because that's what you want for us. So it's in your name we pray. Amen.